So I've been using the Steam Deck for almost a year now, and I've been experimenting a lot with it. And one of the things I've tried since the beginning is to see how easily and well can it play games from other launchers, and especially Epic Games. So I've done a couple of videos a while back on how to use two different launchers to play your Epic Games library. That were Heroic Launcher and Lutris. You can find those videos in the description. But the thing is, at the time, each had its advantages, but both failed on being the overall better solution. With Heroic Launcher, you could get the better result, but it required some tinkering and installing additional things. It was functional for sure, but it took some time to make even just a game playable. And this kept me from even downloading games from my library most of the times. Well, with the newest release, and currently that's 2.5.2, my main negative points have been solved, and we'll get into them. So in my previous videos, I showed you how to add your games as a standalone ones in your Steam library. I'll not go into details, but it required a bit of time. You can catch my full video down in the description. Well, this functionality has been finally added natively into Heroic Launcher. You can choose to add each game individually, or you can simply enable this global setting and you're all set. And the best part of it is when we are back in the gaming mode, the game will appear at first as a non-Steam application, but it has all the posters and pictures available exactly as you have for your Steam games. I'm so thankful for this functionality to finally be here. But we are not done yet. A big question I always got from you guys in the comments at my previous video was if you can install games on an SD card, and unfortunately that was not possible at the time. Well, now you can. The process could be a bit easier for sure, but it is functional. Whenever you install a game, you can choose the path where to do this. And now you can select the SD card and choose a folder of your own in order to do this. Unfortunately, moving the already installed games from the Steam Deck to SD card is not that easy yet. You can even see over here the total amount of space that you still have available on your SD card. And once you set your path to the SD card, you just simply hit install. So with these two big improvements since we last time visited the Heroic Launcher, I can finally say that this app will always be present on my Steam Deck, especially with the growing library that I have with Epic giving away so many free ones. But there is still something that they need to fix in Heroic Launcher. I've looked online and this doesn't seem to be a generic issue, but it has happened to me and others. Whenever I install a new game and I hit play, I get an error that my wind path is not selected, even though this is something I've done before installing the game. So as you can see, the error is that wind was not found, and I have to select a new version. But there is a quick workaround which has worked for me every time. After you get this error, simply go into game settings by clicking the wheel over here, change the wind version to something else, then switch it back to what you originally had. Now go back to the library and hit play again, and this will solve your issue. It's not ideally, but it will work. And if you still find yourself not knowing which Proton version to select, there is a great website called protondb.com which will let you know which is the Proton version that is known to work for each game. The community is quite active there, so please make sure to check it out. So that's about it for the follow-up video on the Heroic Launcher. I can finally say that this is almost as easily as playing games directly from Steam, and I really hope to keep on getting great updates for this launcher. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments, and until next time, this is the Tech Unravel, and I'll catch you in the next video.